Break and run by Dad. Well, they almost didn't do that against me. Alright. I'm back. Vilmos playing good. Just left the window for Dad here. Thanks everybody for staying up and watching. Another long day. It's this is brutal. This is exhausting, but here we are. Nice shot. Just gonna bump the 9 here and get perfect. Wow. Could not have hit that ball any better. I hope Dad wins. He hasn't won a Mez Wesley Tour stop, has he? Has he? Okay. Dead straight, I think. Nifty shot. That looks a lot fresher than everybody here combined. Same by. I said, I have it too. Can you see it? Like this? 2-0 pops. Race to 11, one race finals. Three ball looks good. Dry break. The four ball's tough. Two ball's tough. One ball's tough. Vemos has his hands full this out. Almost ended up straight on this ball. It should be okay. Should be able to draw it out, but it's always nice to have a little angle. A little weak. A little weak on the draw stroke. Just got to use the 10 as a rail now and draw off it. Nice shot, Vilmos. Vilmos is playing great. Thank you. Oh, wow. He might have been on the worst place on the table. It's got to do something here. Alright, just took what the table gave him. A little risky. Here, another danger is leaving himself jacked up over the 10 ball. Unless he spins at 3. Yeah, he's spinning at 3 rows. And he's perfect. Nice shot. Here. Miss hit the break. Yeah, I've almost miss hit the break there. And left my dad a wide open table. Straight on that too. I guess not. Got a little bit of angle now. 5 ball in the upper right hand corner. Ooh. Doing pops. The stream's choppy. Nice shot. 6-8. This is the game right here. This is the table, right? This is a huge shot. Nice shot. Too much juice, Dad. Too much juice. Now, he's got to whip it in the side. 3 cushions. Or play safe. Got kind of like the safety here, but oh, look at that roll. Whew. I got a roll. And Vilmos left a window. He left some type of window, but not enough to make it.
I'm guessing the kitchen is closed,
Bad shot, Vilmos. Bad shot. Yeah, I think he might have given him a quarter ball safety. Alright, well, my apologies if you think I'm knocking him. He's one of my best friends, so. Whatever. The yard line. You can shoot in the side or the corner, personal preference. I like the corner, but the camera angle reads the corner better, but we'll see. Side it is. I don't know why it seemed real steep in the side. It made it look easy. You hear it in me. Okay, that's fine. That's okay, guys. Who cares? We're out here having fun. Now, 3-1. Pops is up. Everybody's running on fumes right now. Chris Byers, kid from Portland, got fourth, was telling me that he could hardly stand. brakes. See how his brakes working. Let him go. Let him down, I should say, last time. Miss hit the brake. And got fortunate there to catch the ball four rails, but that ball goes quite often, so. He hit it kind of firm. And let's see, probably center table. Shoot the two ball in the lower right hand corner. I don't like playing it for the side. Yeah, just like that. Or keep running and he's a little short. But he could go behind two cushions behind the four on the short side of it. Good shot. I wonder if the six ball goes clean. Uh-oh. That's going to leave a mark. He can kick under it, call it in the side off the seven. He can kick after it and try to kick it two cushions. This is a tough shot here. I think he's going to kick it two cushions, short, long, and split the five. That's what I think he's going to do. And he got away with it. Maybe. I think it leaned just enough for him to see it. It's tight. Even if he does see it, he's going to be straight in on the ball. That's a big if, though. Not sure what he's calling. I guess he just called it in the corner off the cushion. I'm assuming that's the only pocket he can possibly even consider calling. That's a good shot. Big scratch here. The two cushions from behind is a huge scratch. Oh, he's kicking underneath it. How? I would like to see this. I think he's going to hook through the gancho, though. And he's going to hook it. Look at that. Nice hit. Got a little roll there. Actually, a big roll. Considering my dad hooked himself on a relatively easy out, he's fighting this game pretty well. And try to leave dad a bank. That's the shot. It's a nice shot. Play containment. Bank towards the eight kind of stinks. It's not really on. The cut is definitely not on unless you go rail first. The safety, it's pretty brutal. I think he's going to send the cue ball two cushions and hit the third cushion, hook him behind the 10 as his primary target. Oh, that's a nifty shot if he gets them. Yeah, nice shot. Seemed a little risky, but executed it well. And let's see, what did he, I didn't hear him call anything. Could he thin the five and carry him the eight? Uh-oh, no cushion. Cue ball barely hit a cushion. And he survived another inning. Nice shot, Vilmos. Now the six ball's in a precarious position. Goes in off the seven in the side. It goes a lot cleaner into the corner near the eight. Is he really calling the ten? As a matter of fact, he is. He called it. Seems like a little bit of a desperation shot. Well, considering where he was at, I guess I'd rather shoot to win too. Wow. Did he really just make that? Wow. Suicide shot. I like to call them those suicide shots. You make it, you're a hero. You miss it, you're a bonehead. I thought he would like cut the ball and bank it, but I don't know. Worked out. Anyways, neither here nor there. 4-1, race to 11. And Vilmos scratched on the break. Kind of let go of it a little bit there. He didn't hit that too solid. Hit a little bit too much draw. He got a bad kiss though. See, the 1 to the 2 to the 3. Everything's in play. It's just a matter of controlling your cue ball and maintaining concentration. This is a good rack to have when you're feeling a little tight. You know, pocketing a couple balls. Let your arm loose. That's a good shot. I'd rather do that than go two rails long. Drawing it there is a lot easier. Now I think he's a little straight. Might have to draw it between the 7-10 and come around center table. And he didn't draw it very well. Well, actually he did, never mind. Got a lot more speed than I thought. And baby draw, center table. He didn't really draw it much. I guess he elected just to stop it and cut it and shoot the seven in the opposite corner. Shot. And he's straight on this nine. A lot straighter than I'm sure he wanted. Low left. And he is in a little too far. These balls skid a lot. I hate them. I like to shoot this with outside. Just like a tip or two of outside. To one. Now, that's right, Vilmos scratched on the break. Left the open table. Now it's Dad's break, and seems like the table hasn't been breaking that great, but when my dad played for the hot seat match, he was, looked like everything was going real well. Thank you. seems to be hitting a little bit off. And three ball. No. Two ball is not tied. I believe the two ball does go, but barely goes. Vilmos now has a prime opportunity to get back going and get something going. Not an easy out. Very difficult layout here. He's got a touchy draw shot. See how he plays this. Well, I guess the two ball's tighter than I think. He's got to draw this ball absolutely perfect if it's that tight. Was weird. He had a little bit of angle to follow that in. He must have made it thick and follow the cue ball right in. That's
costly.
Yeah, that's a big no-no considering the situation here. He almost can't afford to get himself deeper in a hole. And what Pops has to do is
execute.
Zip it two cushions. Come close to the side, but not that close. All right. Left himself a generous angle. Too much for my taste, but I think that should be okay. As long as he gets steers clear of that 10 ball plays pretty big here. I like to hit it with a little bit of speed in case I do hit the 10. It's got to bear down here. That one well. No, he's perfect. Anything but straight here on the six, and he's in good position. Dad's playing well. There's personal preference, it's just rolling it for the side of the corner. I like the corner. I definitely like the corner here. Yeah, that was the right shot. You give yourself so many more options. You can go two rails, one rail, draw. Infinite possibilities. Two rails outside English. You're going to see three cushions. The cue ball is going to end up pretty much where it's at now. A little too firm, but he's ideal.
Pops is playing great.
Yeah, I mean,
hope he can keep it up for five more games. That's all he needs.
Yeah. 6-1, alternate break. That's massive. Considering he was sitting down the whole time for like 3 hours and he could just gets up in front of his chair and starts running out. He's disgusting. That's okay. All right. Now we're on break. It's so late, guys. I kind of forgot about the sponsors.
No, you didn't. Zan tips. Pretty sure everybody's starting to play with these.
Yeah, award's getting out. It's getting more and more popular. I actually placed an order with Japan, and they told me there was a big back order on them. So, goes to show you, something's going on. And
how about the Rocket? He missed this event. He usually plays all of them. He's out in Saratoga, Wyoming.
Snapping it off.
Snapping off 2 out of 3 events. I think he got 3rd in the 8-ball.
He plays okay, I heard.
Yeah, that Rodney Morris guy. I heard he plays pretty good.
I wonder if that bar table guy was Moscone Cup points.
He won a... What is Saratoga?
Saratoga is like an odd game where it's 8-ball but in order.
8-ball? Oh, so like rotation 8-ball.
Basically, but with 13 balls and not 15.
Oh.
So you get 6 solids and 6 stripes.
So it's basically rotation 7-ball, but with an 8-ball?
Exactly.
That's interesting.
I played it. Honestly, I don't even remember.
The rules were, I remember watching it, and it was very hard to follow, because I didn't really understand what you guys were doing.
Yeah, you know what it was? And the balls were like different colors and different stripes, so it was kind of...
Yeah, because it's so hard for someone to follow it on the live stream.
It was impossible for someone to follow it on the live stream. Like, you're playing and we can't even follow. Like, I played Mika was shooting the wrong ball. And, of course, I'm like, Mika, you know, you're shooting the wrong ball, bud. It's like, oh my god. And, he struggled. We both struggled. Nice break. Look at that break. How's that break? Kind of got a bad kiss there. You know, he was flush right in the center of the table. He got a bad kiss. Now he's got to make a tough one. Probably run into the 5. If he misses the 5 coming in, he is, he's going to have to come all the way down the table. This is a tough shot here. Down 6-1. Yeah, look at this. Look at this. Little two-way shot.
No, I don't think we'll ever do bar box tournaments, for those wondering in the chat room.
No.
There's just not enough, there's nowhere out here that has enough bar tables to really hold an event of this size.
Yeah, you're right. There really isn't. Probably
Bull
Shooters.
I mean, the only place is Bull Shooters. Vilmos? Vilmos? Sorry guys, we had someone calling in for info about the tournament.
There's nothing wrong with Bar Box, just...
Nothing wrong with Bar Boxes, we just don't have enough anywhere that has enough tables to actually host one.
Yeah, it's just...
We get 128 players even on a bar table, it just makes it tough. Bullshooters is the only one, and even they don't necessarily have enough. Yeah. They only have about 12.
Yeah, in California, there's really no rooms with a lot of bar tables. I mean, Mr. Lucky's has like 6. I mean, yeah, that's just non-existent. Not for the fields we garner.
We had talked about doing a doubles bar table event, but we just couldn't find a venue that would host it. It was big enough.
Yeah, it's just... It changes the dynamics of the whole rankings and stuff and the whole tour. It's just... Right now, I think we have a pretty good thing going. I think the results...
If it isn't broken, don't fix it.
Right? Yeah. I think we have a good... I mean...
I like the bar table. I don't like the 9-footer, but that's me. Because I stink at pool, so I like the bar table is a little easier for me.
I like the bar table. It's,
bar table is fun.
Bar table has its own allure. It's a different game. I don't necessarily like it for like big events, but I've actually never gambled on the bar table. Weird. But Mr. Lucky's one has it. Alright, whatever. Anyways, Ernesto Pops is halfway hooked. I don't know.
You looked at it. I'm not sure that's what he's looking at.
He's going to have to draw the cue up behind the 8. I don't know.
And nice try.
That's going to leave a mark. And this is a tough shot. Vilmos can't really cue low because he's too close on the cushion. If he cues high, he's going to run into the 4. He's going to have to develop this 4 ball somehow. I think if he just runs dead into it, I think he should manipulate a shot. Tough shot. Uh-oh. Crap.
Where's the Vilmos from like an hour ago?
Wow.
I wasn't expecting that from him.
Yeah, you know what it was? He actually hit it right, but he hit it too fat. If he would have hit it a little bit thinner, then he probably would have accomplished what he wanted to do, which was bump off the 4.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. That changed everything there. That was like Vilmos' opportunity to kind of get some type of pressure back. And Dad doesn't seem to be slowing down at all. It's got a good rhythm, good concentration. I think we need to go vegan, Desiree. This guy, 6 years old and he's got more energy than all of us. It's perfect. Not perfect. He's a little too over the 8, but he should be okay. Outside English, 2 cushions. It's nice to put outside on this ball. Yeah, it helps turn the 8 in. And now if you're a little too straight, you can just punch it forward for the side. Or you can draw it towards the corner. Personal preference. That was touchy. That was a touchy shot there. That was a lot more difficult than what it seemed. Well done. Well done. 7-2. Vilmos has to win 9-3 to win Hill Hill. He has to win more than 3-1. Or 3-1 he has to win. A very daunting task to do against anybody, let alone someone who's firing good shots at you. Let's see Vilmos' break. Last break you got real bad hit on it and a real bad place.
Nothing is going right for Vilmos at the moment.
I think the brakes abandoned him completely.
And he broke a Grand 3 on you, right?
Yeah, he ran a lot of wrecks on me. Well, you know, it's exhausting.
Yeah.
It's tough action. He's, jumped off the table. He got kicked in twice. He broke dry once, I believe.
Pop mean, that's, said, I'm winning this event. I haven't won one yet.
That's right,
Pop. I'm winning it.
Look at this. A little goofy already with ball in hand.
Oh my. Exhaustion is kicking in.
Now he's going to kill it with low inside draw. Center table. Look at that. He actually put a little bit low outside draw kill. Here, the six ball plays big here.
Not for Ernesto.
He hit it well. He hit it very well.
He's playing well, and James Harris actually called it earlier. He said that Ernesto is playing the best out of everybody here today.
You know, I didn't really get to see Dad play until the hot seat, really. He's leaving himself good angles, pocketing good shots. It'd be nice for him to do well over in San Antonio. Uh-oh. Oh, he overzipped it. And left himself straight in. Actually, I believe he's got a little bit of angle. He can punch it with high right punch. And he should generate enough spin to pass the side pocket. Now he's a little short.
Now he's got a little bit of work to do.
Now he's just got to bear down and roll this ball in. Nice. Two tips of outside English. He actually cinched the ball with outside English. A lot of people think he should be using center ball net. I really don't think you should. I think running English really helps play that ball.
Helps the net ball in.
Yeah, it helps play it natural. Helps it play natural. Very nice three cushion position, and now
Vilmos concedes 8-2.
Wow.
And Pops is breaking.
Now we got Pops to break. He hasn't been breaking spectacular, but he's been hitting the ball solid and making that four reller. He's been making the two or three ball in the four rels. And the three ball is going again. And look at this. He breaks dry, leaves a one in a good spot, and Vilmos is in dead jail. He's
sometimes
in Alcatraz.
Sometimes it's just not your day against some people. Vilmos played well against you, and he got a few rolls at the end.
Yeah, he did.
And I think now the rolls have kind of reversed for him. It's all part of the process, like Dad would say.
Let me see here. pushing out to a peculiar position.
I mean, there's no way Pops is going to take this.
He pushed out to me in some of the weirdest positions, and I'm like, go ahead. Go ahead.
Yeah, Pops is not going to take this.
That's,
This is a... I mean, I want to know what he's going to do.
I'll tell you what he's going to do. He's going to try and kick it. And I don't see him having good results.
Just kicking.
What in the world? You can see it.
He made us all look stupid.
What
the? This even Pops is... What the hell?
We all need our eyes checked after that. Nice shot, almost.
Did you even think you could see?
No, I thought he was pushing out to a kick. It had to a back cut. Oh. Made it a little fat. Wiping his cue down. He almost is a Mez player. Close to the cushion. He should be okay, but he hit that a little bit on the weaker side. Okay, now this requires a good shot here. You want to get off the cushion. You don't want to get near the rail. And he is tree-topped a little bit on the 8. He should be okay, though. Oh, come on, man. Get out the way, guy.
Where did he come from?
I don't know. He's a ninja.
There's no one even playing over here.
Come on, man. Now here he's got a pinch draw it. Let's see what he does. Very nice stroke. A little short, but actually I think he wanted to leave himself like that so he can easy. It grabs the three cushions easier. Yeah, that was. I think that he did that intentionally. And he got himself on the rail. Should be okay, but nobody likes shooting off the rail. He should be okay.
Got it.
Nice shot there by Belmos. That was tough. Put a little bit outside English while frozen on the rail.
Cut 1-3 makes it
8-3. And Belmos is breaking.
No. Oh yeah.
Yeah, Belmos.
I'd like to thank Ozzy Reynolds at CSI Pool helping us out with the Ustream.
Yeah.
They're always doing big things over at CSI. Those Fargo ratings are pretty cool. I don't know if any of you have been able to check them out, but they're pretty cool. What do you think about the Fargo rating?
Yeah, I like it. So
it's going to take a little while to develop to get real high.
Yeah, because I remember I think Johnny was playing and he was breaking and he was like a 75% underdog on a bar table. It was like, well, not that bad. I'd bet the wedding fund, babe, getting those odds.
No shot?
He broke well, but again, dry. It's like,
does Pop have a shot?
No, he's
completely snookered.
Halfway snookered. He can swerve
it. The two doesn't go anywhere.
He's going to have to play position for the bank. and he came a little short, but actually he came perfect because he can thin the ball and leave it right into the nine or play the cross side and follow through it.
So he's playing the cross side.
Yeah, he's playing the cross side. Look at the high spin. You see that? How he follows through the ball? He got fortunate there. I mean, and that seven ball just killed off a lot of his rails. Mm-hmm. We're burning the candle at both ends here at California Billiards.
Holding a lighter in the middle.
And we still have to tear
actually,
it down.
Actually, with 116,
we're not doing too bad. No, we're not. Let's see. Whoa, where's he kicking? Oh, nice try. He gets an A for effort. The two ball might not go. It is real tight. Regardless, I think my dad's going to like to thin off the right side of the two. Bank the two ball behind the five. Send Whitey down two cushions, possibly three. Looks like it goes. Yeah, here it goes. He's got to run. He's got to run. I think he can see the outer edge of it, but I don't think he can make it. He shook his head, so no. And out comes a jumper. I think it's like a quarter ball safe. Well, the good news is if he happens to make it, the four ball's a stop shot. It's perfect right there on the side. The bad news for Vilmos is he can easily hit this ball. It's almost a guarantee to hit because it's such a light jump. Let's see how he hits it. I think my dad's like maybe 50-50 here. 50-50 to make this.
Keep it out.
I think you can see the outer edge of it. Or swerve it and hit the outside edge, which I believe is a correct shot.
He's jumping.
He's jumping again.
Didn't he do this earlier?
Yeah.
Or was it you?
No, he jumped both. Except he fouled. Yeah, he fouled.
Okay,
and he is in trouble. Let's see if Vilmos can
rally
a couple games his way. Wait, what? Nice shot by Vilmos. Another key ball here is a 7. Excuse me. Absolutely perfect. Slight angle on the 6 to go towards the 7. Leaving himself on the rail at long rail is ideal. Vamos is waking up. Let's see how he hits this ball. Well
like
done.
Vamos.
Well done, well done. I wonder if Attila's watching.
And Vamos is closing the gap, one game at a time. In case you're wondering, Vamos is playing with a Mez Q. Oscar's playing with a Mez Q. Who's playing with us? Mika, Alex,
Jason Klatz. A lot of Japanese players. Jeffrey DeLuna.
We're all playing with Mez Qs. If you're curious, thinking of trying one out, you can come to any tour stop. We have all the shafts for you guys to try. Oscar knows a great deal about all of them.
And the good thing is if there's something you like or there's something you're leaning towards or something you don't like about Predator, I can pretty much tell you the pros and cons of each shaft, because I've tried them all, and how they compare versus the other brands. Obviously, for some people, Mez isn't the appropriate choice.
Depending on their show.
Yeah, depending on how their style of play.
So Pop's made three balls here, but doesn't have a good shot on the one.
That eight ball almost carried the one in.
Yeah.
That would have been really, really, like, awesome for Pops. I think he's going to thin the ball, send the cue ball right below the six ball, and send the cue ball down table, and bank the one on the short rail. Short rail, short rail. He can hit this ball fat and spin, which I think is... Oh, he's tree-topped a little bit. That was a shot. That was a shot. Those are shots that separate the men from the boys. You know, you keep putting your opponent in precarious positions like this, short rail, short rail, short rail, short rail, kicking all day. It's going to wear on you. I don't care how good you play. I've seen the best players in the world make mistakes. And look at this shot. What a great shot. What a great shot. Now my dad's got to hit the long rail first and play like a one pocket safe and slide the cue ball behind the two ball. Well, either that or you might try to swerve it in. He's playing it. Look at that. He overdid it. Wow. Amazing. Now he's going to have to use the 8 ball to bounce off the... He's going to have to make the 1 roll forward. This will make it 8-5. Make it interesting. Oh boy. And you got a favorable roll there. Very easily could have hooked himself. Thank you. Uh-oh. He made this shot a little bit more difficult than what it had to be. Nice shot. Now he's got to run up and down and play good position on the 8. Oh my god. Played it that way. Brave soul.
He's mounting a comeback. I'd like to thank one of our sponsors, Turtle Rack. We use the Turtle Rack in every match that we have here. It helps get a nice solid rack, keeps those front balls from having a gap, and it speeds up the process a little bit.
See how Vilmos breaks.
He's been struggling with the break today. So.
And he hit it well. And here we go. Two balls, not easy because it only fits in one pocket. Three ball's definitely not easy, even though it's over the side because of the position of the two. So, Vilmos has a chance, though. It's always nice to be shooty. It's going to draw it out.
Little fun fact, Vilmos hasn't won a tournament this season, and Pops hasn't won one at all. So either way, this will be their first, either one of them will be their first victory this season.
It's a tough shot here. Low outside. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Now this is catastrophic for Vilmos. Okay. Alright, let's see if Vilmos comes out. See if Vilmos can pull a trick out of his hat. A rabbit out of his hat, I should say. It's calling three in the side. Risky, because you're kicking it thin. You're aiming to hit it thin. When you aim to hit it thin, you might miss the whole ball. Oh, well, he called it. Called the wrong ball on the side, though.
Poor Vilmos, that's a tough break.
That changed everything if Dad runs out. But considering the position of the 3 to the 4 to the 5...
Tough.
...to the 8 to the 9, I mean, it's...
tough break for Vilmos.
Yeah, I'll be very surprised if my father doesn't run out.
Considering how late it is, there's quite a few people here.
Yeah, the railbirds are still here, still strong here.
about 20 people left. You guys leave on Tuesday.
Yeah, we fly out Tuesday. There's one place you're not supposed to be, that's straight in. And guess where Dad's at?
Yeah, but the sixth spot's sitting nicely, and you can always roll it in this hole.
Not really. Okay. It's just got to draw it straight back and shoot in the opposite side. Man, he's making this way tougher than it needs to be. If he doesn't get out here, he blows a gold mine of an opportunity. Wow. Like I said, much harder than what it has to be.
Surprised our traveling rail bird isn't here.
Oh, yeah.
He usually makes it to everything. We won't name him. We won't name any names, but we have a traveling royal bird who comes and bets on all the matches, no matter where we go. He doesn't play. Shows up day two just to bet on matches. Bonus goes and concedes that game.
Now we got 9-5. Wow, what a change from 8-6 to 9-5. From mounting a comeback to just getting his legs chopped off from underneath him. He almost is disgusted because
he knew that was a big game. That went from being down two to being down four.
It wasn't extremely difficult. You know, it was just like a really, really big mishit.
Mm-hmm.
But Vilmos is a champion, so Dad needs to really run out and play well still if he thinks if he's going to win his first Mez West State Tour event. I would like Dad to win. Not just because it's Dad, but just because...
He's never won one.
He's never won one. Look at that break. Dad says that's a three good ball, break for ball, the other guy. You got fortunate there. The one ball tied up with the five.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to go on a limb and say Vilmos hits the right edge of the one and sends Kiwa behind the six. I'm willing to bet on that.
Well, this time of night, they're liable to do anything. I think you're right.
Well, that's what he tried to do. He unsuccessfully did it. But he didn't leave a bank, and he didn't leave a straightforward safety. He's still in a relatively safe position. I kind of like banking the one towards the seven and sending the cue ball two cushions onto the short rail. You protect yourself with that three ball there. Just like that.
And then there was only one table that's dead silent in here.
Yeah, now it's like a church. Vilmos is now based out of Fresno, California. I remember seeing Vilmos in Dubai at the World Championships and in the Philippines. That's where we met, over in the Philippines. He actually beat me and Dad at the World 10 Ball Championships. Wow. And that's why he's a junior world champion.
All right, guys, we're going to keep our commentary pretty minimal at this point, because it's dead.
It just
And the players can hear us just because it's so quiet.
Yeah, the volume just went extremely low.
Sit back, relax, enjoy some pool.
Turn on some Pandora, play some tunes. They've all skid or what? They've all skid. It sounded goofy. Yeah, they're all skid. Tight, tight, okay. Hell of a shot there. Hell of a shot. He's far from out of this woodworks here. Four ball's in a nice position. You can follow forward with outside. A little left-handed action. That's not good. He's gonna roll it soft. Just roll it in. There you go. That side pocket's not a bad option. That's gonna leave a mark.
Yeah.
Hey, twisted. Three cushions now. Ooh. Nice shot. A little too far.
It has been cut to 3. This is 2 away from winning. Vilmos has got to win 5-1 right now, which isn't impossible.
No, it's very possible, especially with the pressure. Now let's see if Vilmos's break abandons him again, because it's been abandoning him all match. He got one good break in. For the most part, he hasn't had good results, so. Let's see if he hits a square. mishit it, but seven is in.
Three kisses. Oops. Three kisses to get it in, but it's in.
Yeah, he mishit the one. You know, it drifted a lot towards the outside side.
Seven kissed off the six, then the two, then the eight.
Yeah, well, he hit him hard, so a lot of moving parts.
Mm-hmm.
Something's bound to go in. Pretty steep angle, but it should be okay. He's perfect. Actually, I'm going to go out and say he runs out here. Biggest issue here is 8 to the 9. Boy, he ended up straight on that four. Okay. Let's see how he's gonna approach this. Yeah, high outside. He's not that straight, apparently. Was very straight. Made a good shot. Nice shot. I think the 9-ball only fits in one pocket. One lower pocket, I should say. Oh boy, he's straight. He's not happy. Oh my goodness. Do that. That's insane. I can't believe he shot that. Uh-oh. You know, if you can hit that rail that hard, wouldn't it be appropriate to go outside English and come straight across? Well, what do I know? This is the match game. I think whoever wins this game wins the set. Difference between 10-7 and 9-8. I think it's pretty safe to say that mathematically. Broke, excellent. 3-ball is tracking.
No shot.
But He is shooting. I believe you can see the absolute outside edge. Even then, I don't think it's enough.
To do anything.
Yeah, that's...
He's in a bad spot.
I would probably... He's in a pickle. He is in a pickle. I'd probably just bank the 5 into the 7 and just tie up the 7 with the 5. I really don't see anything else you can do. That's a very unusual push. I'm not saying it's bad, just unusual. I did not see that at all. I don't know. We'll see.
Did he hit the one?
Mm-hmm. Now he's going to freeze him up.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of hard actually because the cue ball's frozen now. Or almost frozen. If he plays it on the side, he's going away from the position. It's just nothing easy. Good shot. This is a cool shot here. This is a cool shot. I think he's gonna hit it. Oh. A little unfortunate there. But great safety by Vilmos. So we got the 1-5 combo. Now, if he eliminates the 5 ball, now he's going to go travel for the 4 to the 6. Not that it's a huge deal, but it's something he needs to do. Now, this is a touchy shot here. Maybe not. perfect. It almost isn't missing balls. I mean, it's really impressive how well he's shooting. Inside English. Now this is a shot. If he ends up too low on the six, that's a problem. He's got a big angle. He's gonna run into the seven. A little too hard. This is a touchy shot. I think he's gonna elevate a little bit and grab the seven, because if he hits it flat, he's not gonna reach it. It's too thin of a hit. I think he's gonna spear it. Yeah, he's celebrating. Oh boy. This is what I was talking about. He's going for it. He's going for it. He's going to hit it with a good speed. The only danger here is overcutting it. Perfect. Wow. Way to come with it. Just like that, it's 9-8. We got ourselves a ball game. You know it's gonna go hill. Three ball rattled. The nine ball looks good. Hang up. Now, the one ball goes off the three. Whew. Talk about pressure. Talk about pressure. You can bang it to a cushion, send the cue ball underneath the four. You can play the aggressive route. It's just all how you feel. All I know is that there's a lot of pressure on Pops. Did he call a three or did he hear him? Wow. What a shot. What a shot. Fantastic pressure shot. Three cushions inside English. Just beat the four and you're good. Just beat the four and you're good. Now you have to kick the nine in. I actually favored Adam to make this because he can sneak it in from behind or direct. It's a big ball. Yeah. I know my customers. Now this is a shot here. It's probably gonna have to draw it out. The six ball plays big. Six ball plays big, like I said. Outside English on that ball.
Really, I like for us to fire this in, actually.
On the upper right hand corner.
Mm-hmm. He shoots these buff shots real well.
I don't know, Dez. This is a tough one. He does shoot them well, but I don't think he's shooting. Yeah, he's playing it. He's playing it. A big danger here is if you miss it, you can bump the 10. And sell out. It's a big danger. In my opinion.
I told you.
Look at that shot. Sick. He's gonna go 9-9 here if he can get these two balls in. This ball is a key ball here. That's it. Play that position. I mean, what does it matter when you're not missing, right?
You almost fooled us. Game to play.
9-9.
9-9 from what, 8-2?
Yeah, for me too. I really don't care who wins anymore. I just want this over with. I'm dying. So we're back. Three balls is only hope. No, you got fortunate. You mishit that break. Now the 2-8s is only hope of running up. I like him to do well here. I think Dad's gonna make this, and I think he's gonna run out. I don't know why. He's good. He's got angle. He's gonna shoot the upper right hand corner. This is a shot here.
Upper right.
Upper right. This is one of those shots where you win the match or you lose. You gotta play it. Yeah, it's a shot. With speed. Confidence. Stay down. He hit it poorly. And let's see if he almost can capitalize. It's not an easy shot here, but he's favored. The way he's been playing, it's probably a hanger. So good, it's scary. Shot. Oh boy. I'm a little close to the cushion. He's okay. Safety battle, Hill Hill. We're going to be here for another 2 hours. I just come back tomorrow. Pick it all up. Oi. And the 8 ball. Oh my god. Look at this. Well, folks, it's not over. You guys wanted a grind fest? You guys got one. Straight back across and send a cue ball behind the 7. Too weak. I think it's a pretty good shot. That's a great shot. Called something. I didn't hear him what he called, but probably the 5 of the side. Who knows? Or the 1 of the side? I don't know. Great hit. Great hit. But here he goes. Literally. All he has to do is get on the 2, and the whole table is wide open. Pressure will burst pipes, ladies and gentlemen. Pressure will burst pipes. Come on the top side of the 10. He's okay. Wow. I can't believe he just did that. He's just gonna nudge the 8. Nice shot.
That was a pretty shot.
That was a beautiful shot. Stay down and you're good.
Yep.
There's no way we were going to get out of here without a Hill Hill.
Final? Yeah. every match today, almost all of them. Hill, or at least Hill 7. Everyone almost.
Yeah, we got action, ladies and gentlemen.
Breaking. I would love to see a break. Make three balls. Nice one-time combo.
No, you know what's going to happen.
I know. It's going to be a safety battle.
Safety battle. Only two things are going to happen. A safety battle, or he's going to get, he's going to scratch. There's nothing else that's going to happen. Well, congratulations on the tournament, Desiree. Well done. Good job.
116 of you guys. I never understand why we can go from 116 to 32, be out of here at 1, start later, start 2 hours later, get out of here 3 hours earlier. And 32, it just takes 15 hours.
Let's see what
16 hours.
Perfect break for the other guy. What did I tell you?
Yeah, lucky.
Automatic. Safety valve. And look at this, it's such a gross spot. No push out really available. And after this, the table is very favorable. So really, it's a battle to the one to the two. And you get on the two, you can get out of the game. Got a little heart.
So crazy.
Oh, what a hit. Oh, that's a bad roll, but the seven ball is now. That's a bad roll.
Seven ball goes in the side or in the.
Oh, the thing is, here, shooting the one and drawing back is not easy. Especially if it's got a little bit of angle. Safe if he can't do it. Let's see how he hits it.
Excuse us.
Oh my god. I don't think so.
Oh my god. Like, he can't see just enough to
make it. Yeah, he can just see just enough to make it. Yeah, he's out. Normally, under normal circumstances, he's out. Oh boy. Ooh, good shot. He made me nervous jumping up on that ball.
Yeah.
Thank you guys for watching. First of all, we're probably gonna abruptly leave. We're so tired. And here's the shot. Oh boy, look at this. Look at this. Wow.
He knows.
Oh my God. I can't believe he made that mistake.
What mistake? Why don't you tell people?
He straightened on the ball. This is like the worst position he can be in. He's gotta smooth it forward or punch it across.
He's gonna punch it.
I'm smoothing it.
Is he smoothing
it? What a great shot that was. I think he's too straight now.
Let's see.
Oh my God, I can't believe this. He's straight in on this ball. He might just roll in and play the caramel and nine. I don't know what else he can do. Wow.
This ball.
This is goofy. I know. All this because he got funny on the five. Scratched. Oh my God.
Oh my God.
Oh my God. This is the first mistake he's made like in forever. Oh my God.
Clapping.
Oh my God. Did that just happen?
That just happened. And with ball in hand, Pop says no, he make the seven. Does the seven go?
In the corner. It doesn't go. I don't think it goes. You have to play the caro. Oh boy.
Disco. You just spin it.
Just turn it a little bit. Wow. He'll for this.
And let's go, the new guys. Takes it down. Congrats to both players. Thank you all for tuning in.
That was sick.